Hey guys, this is Those Guys with your host Matt Marrero along with the other host
Tristan Walter.
It is Tristan Walter. By the way, so you guys are going to hear us a little bit different than usual. You're going to hear some differences in the audio quality. Maybe you'll hear other things in the background like saws or cats or just a bunch of other random stuff.
Or roaring,
yeah. We are recording this in my home.
Live.
No, we have Tristan over. We're doing a bunch of other stuff as well for other channels like Those Guys Play, TG Productions, and of course this one, Those Guys on the Radio. But we also have him here because you and I just saw Jurassic World, both the original and Fallen Kingdom today. They were doing an event, a double event. So I looked at you and I said, and you said, yeah, we are. You didn't know about it, but the second you knew, you were like, oh no, my body is ready. But yeah, so we went to see it. We got a poster. It's weird because it was technically expensive, I think, by Long Island standards. Mm. But I mean, from the theater that you and I went to see Solo, A Star Wars Story. I love Solo as a name, but I don't know why the other like had to be tagged on. But yeah, so we went to see Solo. It was $6. So for me, I'm like, oh, because in the city, it's like, or just in general, in other parts of New York that I live in or I'm around, it's like $13 or more.
Yeah.
So to do an event like this,
to be fair, that was the matinee price too.
Usually, yeah. To be
it's
fair,
like $12.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair. But I still feel as if it was a really good matinee though, because the matinee that I know, the matinee prices that I've seen around this area are like $8. So being able to go to this double event, we saw both in a row. There was a little behind the scenes for Fallen Kingdom in the middle there, which was nice. And yeah, it was pretty cool. We saw it for $30 each, which sounds like a lot. But again, honestly, if you're going to pay $13 plus popcorn for one movie, paying $30 for both and then one is new, I don't know. And also like a little bit more, like a dollar or two more for that whole event experience.
Right, yeah.
I didn't hate it.
Yeah.
You know, I don't do it that often, right? But I think also another good thing too is that it was a new movie, so it was just, and it also just came out too. It's not like though I love older films, it's not like it's a 30-year-old movie that they're like, you could get it on Blu-ray, but watch it here. And I'm like, I might stick the $10 Blu-ray,
right.
But anyway, so we saw Fallen Kingdom, and this is what we're going to talk about. Friday Night Movies, Fallen Kingdom. It's in the YouTube, it's in the title of the video.
Yeah, because technically Fallen Kingdom doesn't come out until tomorrow.
Oh, so then did we see it a day early?
Yeah.
Ha ha ha, never mind. So are we hip to the times? Do we have something out the week? We still haven't done the second Pacific Rim. I'm waiting for it to come out on DVD.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, damn. This is actually really cool. So, Tristan, what did you like about the movie? I'm kidding. No. He's doing things in the background as well because it's not caught on the mic. So, because we're both in the same place, he can just walk in and out of the room. And as long as it's not caught on the mic, it's fine. So, I just wanted to get him in an inopportune moment. Like, Tristan, you're not so close to the mic. What are your thoughts on the entirety of the film and cinema as a whole and how we've come so far? No. Well, you know what? Right off the bat, we're going to hit you with the hard-hitting questions right off the bat.
Okay.
Jurassic World 1 or 2, which is better? Because I think, because if we take the original 3 into account, I think most of them, not smoke, but they definitely outdo these two.
Yeah.
In some respects, if not most respects. Not all three, but just many, many different parts of at least 1 and 2.
Yeah.
But when it comes to just putting Jurassic World 1 and 2 up against each other, where does your brain go?
I don't know, actually. It's pretty close.
Okay. So, you're telling me that Jeffy G didn't push you over the edge?
Not like it did you, no.
No, me? I know. I
now,
was
if they had
there.
Grant, you bet your ass.
So, if they had Grant, you'd be like, I'm in.
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay, that's fair. And frankly, I do think that one of them would have been worth it. Because also another thing, too, I feel like this trailer, in a way, misled us. In some ways, I'm okay with it because I think I'm happy that they didn't show. And by the way, this can be complete spoilers if you didn't know, if anyone doesn't know. So if you don't want spoilers, please don't.
wait a few weeks to listen to this one.
Yeah, wait a little bit. I was worried that there wasn't going to be any, and you were too. We were talking about this just you and I off podcast, I believe. That there wasn't going to be any InGen kind of focus, that they were doing the Star Wars model of, well, we're passing it off, even though I think I saw from the credits, Colin Trevorrow, he also worked on Jurassic World 1. Still, I was worried that they were kind of doing this passing baton of storyline ideas. Like, right. even though it's a trilogy and it's a planned trilogy, little bits and pieces there will remain, but it's going to be a different story every time. And I wasn't a big fan of that in episode 7 and 8 because I felt like a lot was dropped with Star Wars. No, I'm not saying I didn't like 8, but I'm saying that it felt like certain things that I thought they were going to pick up on, like, oh, why did this happen here? Why did this happen there? They didn't get addressed in 8.
Right.
Yeah. And in this case, they did not do that. They actually addressed a lot of the stuff that came up in the first Jurassic World. If not, I think everything.
Yeah.
They even added some new things that I think are kind of odd, but as long as they are talked about in the third movie, I don't think they're a complete waste.
Right.
Like, talking about the girl who was straight up cloned.
Yeah.
If she is never mentioned again, I will be furious.
Yeah, no, she's going to be mentioned.
She has to at least be mentioned.
Yeah.
You know, like something has to, but you know what the problem is though? They cast a child actress, and I have a feeling even though her nephew's story was told, their story was told, and their family, I mean, they probably broke up, but still, like, they were still like, they became together. Right. That's her name, Claire, right?
Yeah.
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 Claire's nephews, even though the parents probably broke up, as a brother unit, they're very strong, and that's what they need. That's what they kind of needed to have, right?
Yeah.
So we don't need to show them again. But also, that little one, I bet you he had a growth spurt or something in the last 2 years.
Right.
That does not make him... I mean, do you remember the kids from the first Jurassic Park to the second one?
Yeah.
Wasn't it only like, it's been 6 months, you know, with all these trials and all this stuff. And they show the kids, and I'm like, 6 months? Looks like it's been 6 years for you. Jesus.
Right.
Like, it went from, like, the littlest one, the little boy, went from how he looked in the first one to that douchey guy in this one. That's how it took. It took like 2 years, and they just... Well, technically it was longer because it was the third one.
Right.
But it still wasn't like 6 years since all that bullshit went down from 1 to 3. It was like 1.5.
Right.
And he fucking... but anyway. So, when talking about this movie, though, I think that, again, they really made sure to address a lot of the stuff they brought up there. They continued the InGen stuff.
Yeah.
And they also did a good job of setting up the future dinosaur war. Because the thing is...
Which we all saw coming.
It's still odd, though, because I feel like you didn't have to have the dinosaurs being released into the wild to have a dinosaur war.
Right.
You just needed to have InGen get the shit that they needed. Which, to be... Actually, funnily enough... Arguably, I think InGen did not win out, but all the other countries did.
Oh, yeah.
So InGen is actually completely fucked because of that one dude's utter incompetence.
All of that money that they were going to control, like, they were going to control the market. Now it's out. Like, everywhere.
Yes.
Everyone has their hands in genetic modification.
Well, actually, wait a minute. Question. Odd question.
Yeah.
I said they were going to continue with InGen. Did we ever see a logo on the side of a helicopter? Or could we assume that he's a completely different dude? Because why would InGen want to sell to other countries?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Did we not get InGen in this movie? I thought we did, but I don't think they ever said it out loud, did they? Because Henry was working with InGen, yes, but he also...
I mean, because Wu was still technically...
Yes, Wu.
Yeah, Dr. Wu, yeah.
He was there, but he works with InGen still? Because he was working with InGen in the first one, right? Or was he being contracted?
It's throughout the whole thing. It's changed hands so many times now, too.
Okay. No, I'm only asking because I couldn't take notes because we were in a theater, and of course I can't watch it again. I want to clarify, before I say InGen was shown, that they actually had InGen on the side of a chopper.
I don't remember.
Because in the first one they did.
Yeah. I don't remember if it was shown on tech or anything, but no, when they... brought back the piece of the Andominus Rex at the bottom of the bay that the Mosasaur ate in the first one.
The logo was there.
I'm pretty sure they were. Like, that team that went in, we need a bone fragment so we can take
the
DNA
they worked
from.
And then they worked with fucking asshole.
Fuckface McGee.
Thank you, Fuckface McGee. Good, I was looking for something funny. But it's not even funny, it's just accurate.
Yeah.
I can't remember the actor's name was in this movie.
Right.
He plays... He played a Nazi in Captain America.
Right.
Yes, and he's also he's
a famous actor.
I mean, he played the Dream Lord, right, in Doctor Who. And in the 11th
Doctor.
Yes, I love how he's always so good at being a complete asshole.
Yeah.
But then the grandpa, or technically, whatever you want to call him, I guess.
Yeah.
Her dad.
Yeah.
Because he fucking made a clone. By the way, right. So I don't know about you. Old man makes clone girl in laboratory. Does that come off as Dr. Slump to you as it does to me, or no?
I mean, I haven't read a lot of Dr. Slump, so...
But you know about O'Reilly. Do you think... I think she could play a good O'Reilly.
I mean, yeah, that's...
She does seem like O'Reilly.
Yeah, yeah.
But so, it's interesting. What I find very odd is he said you have your mother's sense of humor. That's not how cloning works, though. It only makes sense if...
Oh, no, he said you're... In fact, a spitting image of her.
No, but he said you have your mother's sixth sense of humor, because when she came into the room to talk to him, she was like, oh, I went to the Jurassic era today. There were a lot of fatalities, including the maid, including the lady. Yeah. I don't know what you would call her.
Caretaker.
Caretaker, yeah. Thank you. Including the caretaker, and she was like, Queen's English killed me.
Right. Oh, my God.
Bath, where you're not an animal. Rah!
That was beautiful.
Yeah, no, that was very funny, and I kind of wish we saw more of... Like, I'm not saying I don't like Owen, because I think I like Owen more in this movie than I did in the first one. Mm. I kind of wanted more of them, though. Like, they introduced certain characters that I feel like, in the beginning, I was like, hey, you seem really great. And then, of course, due to the stress and trauma, can't be that way anymore, which is understandable. But then, due to that stress and due to that trauma, everyone becomes the same. Mm. Like, it seemed like everyone at one point or another became the screaming person who's screaming, other than Owen. And also that other woman, the veterinarian.
Yeah.
Yeah, she was very good with the go fuck yourself.
Yeah.
And everything
rolling
that you've
ever... Rolling with the punches in the situation.
Yeah, oh, definitely.
She was great.
But she also disappeared, and I was kind of...
Yeah.
Like that. I think that's the biggest issue with this movie. Disappearing characters.
Yeah, that's fair. Other than Owen and Claire.
Yeah, there we go.
Karen. Claire. Yeah.
Claren.
Like, they're the main focus for a lot of it. Which understandable. Yeah.
Right. Also, I want to mention, I've never seen, and I probably have, and I'm sure you guys have too, if you guys have watched a lot of movies throughout your heyday, I've never seen two actors who are both so beautiful and yet have no chemistry whatsoever. I don't know about you, Tristan, but I don't see anything sexual between them.
Mm.
I see jokes, but to me, at most, they're really good friends who like to have a laugh every once in a while.
Yeah.
It does not seem like there is a will they, won't they thing. And if they get together in three, I'm going to be upset. Am I going to be furious? No, it's a goddamn movie. But am I...
It's funny. I don't know if they'd actually, like, get together.
I hope not.
Yeah, they might.
I mean, especially not for survival.
Just... I knew you were going to bring it up somewhere.
I had to see that scene again, and I had to try to keep an open mind. And you know what? Other people were groaning with me. That's or fair. I was groaning loud enough that I echoed.
Yes, that might have been. I'm like, okay, Matt, like, chill.
No, because I was like, ugh. And I heard someone else, ugh, a little bit before me, a second before me, unless that was me from the future. But just being like, that scene is terrible. You hear an older man? I know, right?
Oh, my God.
Just me.
I just look over. How did you do that?
Right? But yeah, so I'm okay with them never getting together. The kiss was odd.
Yeah. I mean, it always is, isn't it?
No. There's some movies that do it really well. Well, yeah. Or at least I look at you and I'm like, Tristan. And you're like, I know it has to be in this. But I don't feel like it's... I don't know, like... I feel like these two movies don't do a good job of showing them separated, like we're never going to get together, but they also don't do a good job of showing them potentially getting together.
Right.
Like, I don't know. There's just something about them. Maybe they do get along in real life. Maybe they're best friends. Yeah. I'm not trying to criticize them as people.
Right, right.
I just mean that I don't feel a chemistry there.
The characters.
Yeah.
Right.
And I tried to make a mommy and daddy, and I'm like, honestly, yes. They can be mommy and daddy in a very fun, friendly, as friends kind of house.
Yeah,
like when you were in high school and, you know, you made your friend group made a little, like, this is mom, this is dad, this is the kid. You remember that in high school?
Yeah,
yeah. That's a lot different than actually looking at mom and dad and being like, "So, you're fucking, right?" Like, no, no, that didn't happen. You know, mom and dad in high school usually were just two friends in the friend group.
You gotta be able to identify with at least one of those things, right?
God fucking damn it! That was from the movie that we're not talking about today. No, I liked them a lot better here. I liked Pratt better in this one.
Okay.
At least the character. Also, I do think that after watching Guardians of the Galaxy, I can see how he can be funny in that role and mm-hmm. see how it's in some ways dialed down, in some ways kept very similar and lighthearted.
Yeah.
But I think in the first one, because I had never seen him in anything before other than maybe like a clip or like the first episode of Parks and Rec,
right.
he didn't come off as like funny guy with the finger guns. He came off as like, so we're gonna fuck or what? And she's just like, I'm here for work. And he's like, yeah, okay. And it's like, dude, what? Because right. I never saw their dating history.
Right, yeah.
And in my head, I wasn't expecting her to be a terrible human being. Now, funny story, just funny things like watching this movie. Throughout both movies, I feel like the writers have made it more and more and more of a point to make sure that kids know, do not trust Claire.
Oh, no, because right,
like
right.
little clone girl, she's just like, nah, not you. I'm gonna hug him. You actually never even look at me.
Melissa?
I think it was something with an M though.
Yeah.
It wasn't Melissa, but it was like Malaketh. No. It's Malaketh.
It wasn't Madison.
No. But anyway.
Yeah.
Megan? No, it wasn't Megan. No, it was Megan. Definitely not Megan. But anyway. So what do you think about the dinosaurs in this movie? I mean, that's what the fight. Yes. That's what's in the movie. Yes, that's what I thought about them.
10 out of 10.
Would
dinosaur again?
Did you like the way they were portrayed? As our resident dinosaur specialist.
I mean, I will also quote the previous movie before, as Dr. Wu stated. Yes, we have manipulated them genetically. They may not look the way they should.
But now here's the thing. The genetic manipulation, do you think it made sense? That's what I'm saying. I know it's sci-fi, but...
Because it's funny, in real life, mm-hmm. there's actually been tests on chickens.
Right.
And you can re-engineer the feathers into scales.
Okay.
So they look like a raptor. Or how we used to think a raptor would look like. So, like, yeah. I think they could... With the things that they've done in Jurassic Park with their genetic mastery and magic, yeah, I think they could easily do that.
Okay. No, I meant it more so making the, you know, not the Abdominus this time. It was the...
The Indoraptor?
The Indoraptor.
Because it had DNA by the way, of the by Abdominus. The way,
okay. Because you laughed at the name Indoraptor. Is that why?
Kind of.
Do you think it was a scientific name or a movie name? Is that why you laughed? Like, it didn't seem as scientific?
No, it felt like a movie. But, again, it's their own genetic monstrosity.
No, of course. No, but, like, what I mean by that is, like, there's certain times with scientific names that they're kind of, like, long, and you're like, oh, man. But yeah, I say it in terms of, was it a movie name? Because it's, like, it has the Indoraptor. The Indominus gene, we'll call it the Endoraptor. When, really, you'd probably give it a name that has nothing to do with the raptor.
Yeah.
Even if it has the raptor genes, you'd probably find some other big... long, hard to pronounce classification. The not
Death
just
Kill Machine 9000.
No, but you would take parts of all those words and put them together.
Right, fair.
Del 9K. Right. The Del 9K. Oh, the Del 9K. Versus, like, the, you know, the Indoraptor.
Right.
Like, that one, like, calling it the Indoraptor sounds like we're actually watching Transformers.
It grew on me. It was just when he first revealed it, I was just
I saw
like,
you chuckling.
Really?
Yeah.
And then they said it more. I'm like, all right, fine. There's nothing wrong with it. I don't know. I felt with, like, the Indominus Rex, they were going to go with something, like, you know, threatening sounding, not just, like...
Endoraptor.
Yeah. I mean, the word raptor to me is threatening no matter how you say it, but...
Yeah, but it's not, yeah.
So, it wasn't like, you know, it wasn't the, you know,
gravitas. What is that bad?
Yeah. No. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah. Question. So, do you think that so when we had the big meeting, the big the bourgeoisie before the death of all the bourgeoisie, when we had the black market bourgeoisie, we have to clarify.
Yeah,
it's not like we're anti-bourgeoisie. Well, I mean, well, we're anti-bougie behavior.
Yeah.
We're anti people.
Oh, well, this
snubbing.
This was literally a black market sale for
yes, exactly.
animals. For
it was like
endangered species.
It was like Yu Hakusho with the what were they called?
The
were they actually called like they were like
the Black Club.
Oh, they were the Black Club.
Uh-huh.
Well, because in Japanese it's just Braku Braku, so like they don't it doesn't sound like it's same thing with like Goku Black. It's like
right.
Goku Black, and we're just like
guys.
I think Dark Goku would be best for the dub.
Right, exactly.
Anyway, but still when it came to when it came to this movie with the with their version of the Black Club, no, with their black market. Did you think that, and they weren't actual companies, countries, or they were just people who were there as black market companies that that don't represent, like, it wasn't like seeing Russia there was like, oh, that is Russia. No, it's just Russian person who would probably, well, to be funnily enough though, would maybe want it for future wars.
Yeah.
So it could technically a representative. Technically.
Maybe.
We'll have to see in number three.
Yeah. It felt like for him when he walked up, because he spoke to the guy who was running the auction, and he's like, oh, he wants two predators, you know. And it sounded like it was more of like, oh, yeah, I want them to guard my front door.
I want them as
torture devices.
Of course, which is fair.
Which that's what it felt like a lot of these people. It was like, it's all private-owned stuff.
Right, so it's not about... So then, do you think we might have a war then in the third one, or do you think we might have a war like Planet of the Apes style? Let me explain the differences maybe to some of you that don't know. When I think of war that's not Planet of the Apes style, I think of, oh, a foreign country has armed itself with dino nukes or something like that.
Yeah.
Like a dinosaur with armor shooting guns, right?
I've played
versus that
Dino D-Day.
Yeah, that versus Planet of the Apes, where the dinosaurs become a bit more... I'm not saying that they speak,
right,
but they become a bit more
it's us
chill.
Against them.
They actually become a bit more chill in a way, but it's humans that are like flipping them the bird,
right,
saying, no, we're going to kill you. And the dinosaurs are like, what can we do to... Like, we have
can
to
we,
defend
can
ourselves.
Can we not do this? Yeah.
We're
giving you the option to not do this. Please don't cross
that
line.
Yeah, and I'm talking about the new Planet of the Apes, not the old one. Because the old one, different story altogether.
Yeah.
So I'm talking about the remakes, which I haven't seen, but I've heard great things about.
I saw the first one. I haven't seen anything past that.
Yeah, it gets a lot more like...
Yeah, no, I've
you
seen
see
the trailers.
Yeah. Woody Harrelson was in that just like he was in Solo.
Yep.
Anyway, side note. But getting back to the whole... so then do you think maybe we're just going to have the war be more just...
I think it's going to... I feel it's more going to be like private little armies scattered about and like different countries' governments trying to maintain order.
Interesting. Okay.
And then like these people with dinosaurs are going to be like, no, I can rule the I can rule the world now. Sure, I'll throw my hand in.
You know why they might do that? Because they probably don't want to piss off foreign countries that they're going to open the movie in.
Right.
This isn't a US exclusive movie.
Oh, yeah. Right.
If you open it up, if you make, let's say, the villains China.
Right.
You're going to have a hard time selling that to a Chinese market.
Right.
Especially when you might want their revenue both as consumers and as investors.
Right. And, I mean, to be fair, like, within the universe in this movie, it's like, it's not like the U.S. wouldn't buy dinosaurs for military purposes. All right, like, are you kidding?
Just cut it off for military purposes. It's not like the U.S. wouldn't buy dinosaurs.
That too, yeah.
But, so I don't know about you, but I felt like these, because I don't want to call out a specific country, but I'll call out these people from these countries.
Yeah.
They all, to me, felt very, very stingy.
Oh,
I don't
right.
know. Dude, I'm sorry.
You're looking at the numbers.
Well, because, like, I'm looking at the numbers, and I'm like, I'm looking at real,
right,
fucking
the first
real
dinosaurs. Yeah.
All of them that had numbers.
Right.
Even the abdomen, the
Endoraptor.
The Endoraptor. He still got up to, like, maybe the last number that was heard.
125? 100? Oh, no, wait.
It was
that
less.
Was like...
I thought it was less than 100 mil.
No, I think at that point they were getting up there.
Okay. I thought they were going up to 30 mil.
Yeah,
you're
right. 20 million was the starting bid from the Russian dude.
Yeah, well, because the reason why I'm saying this is because I don't think they got that high up there because they were showing,
it was the overall amount.
Yes, that was the overall amount. Because on the computer, they showed an overall amount of how much you're making overall, not
right.
just only bid on him.
Yeah.
But the reason why I think that they're all stingy is because, look, I don't have money.
Yeah.
I'm not a billionaire. I'm not a millionaire. I'm not a thousandaire. But, however, if I had billions of dollars and I was looking into buying a dinosaur, And I assume they have enough money, and I'm just assuming, they seem like the, oh, we own so many companies, yeah. some legal, some not. We're right. we're not, like, they didn't seem like they're $1 million a day people. They yeah. seem like they're $1 billion a day people.
Right.
Like, yeah. if that's the bourgeoisie and they're only millionaires, holy shit, even our bourgeoisie is going down. Right. Even they're suffering. if that's the, oh, those from all different countries, including the U.S., those are the richest people, you know, on, in the underground, and they're only millionaires, I'm like, oh, God, I'm sorry to hear that. Right. Like, so are you falling on rough times? You have to sell that yacht? But still, assuming that they're all billionaires. I
mean, that's what it feels like the selling the dinosaurs for. It's like, oh, I'll buy this one on the cheap, and then I'll sell it for, like, double.
Are you, oh, my God. You've made them even shittier to me. No, because Tristan
dinosaur
thinks...
scalpers.
Yes! You've made them even... As someone who's complained about scalping on our Those Guys Play YouTube channel,
my God.
You essentially made them... Do you understand that you've essentially made them into, like, NES Classic, like, Dinosaur Classic sellers? Like, guys, we only released this... Well, the demand is so high, we have to do a reprinting of dinosaurs.
So then when half of them were murdered in the room, because inevitably it was going to happen, it just yeah. makes it more all the more sweeter.
Yeah. No, I have no problem with that. But what I'm trying to get at, though, is this, right?
I love... No, just like...
Matt Marrero, 2018. I have no problem with murder, but...
You were looking at me for other parts, like, oh, it was... We were watching the first one again, when the guy is, like, sitting in front of the truck, and the Indominus just, like, snaps him up, and I was, like, giggling to myself as he was, like, looking over his shoulder. You're like, you're such an evil porpoise. You're so evil. Like, you're
horrible. You're such an evil porpoise. No, but I the reason why I was mad at you, though, is because, like... This isn't like...
No, I know.
These weren't bad guys. Yeah, right. When we see the bad guys in the second movie, every single one of them, I'm like, it's time.
Right. No, we were both... I'm like, excellent.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, because with the second movie, I didn't like the bad guys in that one, but there's something about them that I just felt like it was odd to kind of shift into, oh, God, we're going to... Yeah. You're going to, like, eat
right.
all of you. Especially because some of them are just soldiers. I know, like, yeah. the following orders thing doesn't actually work all the time, but it's not like everyone was that one dude, right?
Right, right. In it's not like everyone was Hoskins.
Yes. In this one...
Everyone was that dude.
Yeah, every bad guy just came off as that dude. Like, yeah. they had no problem. They didn't seem like they were like, oh, I'm just a hired gun to do this job. It felt more like, no, I've been... We're a part of this
life. Earlier in the film, at the very beginning,
yeah.
they felt a little more hired gun. Mm-hmm. But, like, everybody else that was in this black market dealing was...
Yeah. Oh, yeah. But anyway... But the
funniest part, though, was it didn't start with them getting eaten by the, you know, the Indoraptor, which, don't worry, it happens.
Yeah, right? It's
beautiful.
Oh, it's... I heard Ave Maria in my head when it happened.
But the first, like, because Owen and Claire get out of their cell that they're thrown in when they get captured, they break out with the Pachycephalosaurus, which was beautiful.
Yeah, which is also a Pokemon. He looks just like his Pokemon counterpart, mostly.
Cranidos and Rampardos.
Thank you, yeah.
So, but Owen is like, are you thinking what I'm thinking? And the dinosaur even, like, kind of, like, tilts his head and, like, winks at him almost. It's like, oh, we gonna have fun. And I heard the music in my head. The Packy just starts headbutting people, like, left, right. And you just see all these shitty people go flying across the room. It was beautiful. I was almost in tears.
It was wonderful. And I think it was just something that, like... that I feel as if it's just hard to be against because, again, I'm not, like, pro-murder. I don't think we should have killed. I'm not happy that there's a chance that a bunch of people in the U.S. in this movie canon are going to die because predators are...
Right.
Yeah. They're not all herbivores.
No.
So I do have a problem with that.
There are at least three big predators, really.
Yeah. But the reason why these guys I'm cool with is because I truly believe that you could have replaced all of those dinosaurs with that one cloned little girl, and they would have spent millions to buy her, dissect her, to try to see how to clone humans.
Yeah.
I don't think these are people that are like, oh no, that's too ghastly me.
These are people that would, they don't give a fuck.
They don't give a fuck. No. And so I was okay with that. And it's funny too, because you and I love capitalism. It's just that people like this are like, eh.
It's the dark underbelly. Yeah.
That I'm like, no, you deserve to die. Ah, it's happening. That's wonderful. That feels good. It feels good. It feels good. But anyway, no, but the reason why I was calling them cheap, though, is because when you are telling me, Matt, this is a one-of-a-kind, These don't exist anywhere else. They're all dead now.
Yeah.
Truly dead again.
Right.
They die the second time around, too. And it's only, like, what, 12 left?
Well, they had 11 different species that they captured from the island.
But they didn't capture, like, multiples. Not like there's, like...
No, they may have had, like, one or two of each.
Maybe, but I'm saying maybe there's, like, 18 is what I'm saying. Because it looked like everyone that was released downstairs,
yeah,
including those that were upstairs. So, what, maybe 30?
No, not that much. Like,
it's teams, what I'm saying is, yeah, super limited edition. If you're thinking about it and from scalping, super limited edition, and you're going to sit there and be like, I bid 10 million. You know what? You're a piece of shit. You're a piece of shit for so many other reasons. And now you're going to lowball them on dinosaurs?
Oh my God.
Really? If you're that much of a dick, just go home. Like, right, I feel like, yeah, the first response should have been, like Henry Wu should have been, right, like, oh, I didn't realize we were going to be assholes today.
Right. Oh my God.
Please, Wu, Mr. Wu, calm, right, down.
The only time he gets up is like, oh, when they start selling, because people are like, oh, 20 million for the Indoraptor. He's like, ah, that's a prototype. We have not perfected that. It's a killing machine. We need to perfect that before we start selling it.
Speaking of video games, you know what I said my first response was in the, yeah, theater? I was like, why are you selling them that one? Just make them pay the price,
right,
and have it be like a pre-order.
Oh, and yeah.
It's a pre-order, and as a pre-order bonus, you get raptor jeans in there.
Oh my God.
It's a pre-order bonus, and you get a hoodie that says, I'm a scumbag.
Yeah. Oh God.
But you
no,
see where...
you get a, instead of beware the dog, mm-hmm, you get beware the endo. And people are like, what the hell is that?
No, people are like, oh my God, the design on this was amazing. Oh, it really was. Sadly, we had to kill the artist after. We couldn't let them get out knowing that this was a real thing.
God.
Oh, that's terrible. They were such a good... Oh, you should buy their stuff now. It'll be worth much more later. Once people find out that they've died. Oh! God.
Smothers the artist with a pillow, just like the grandfather.
Jesus Christ. So that's one of the most... That is one
that
of the...
Dark. Yeah.
It's okay that it's dark.
Oh, yeah.
It's just bullshit because this is such a big action movie that, yeah, we can't focus on the fact that, like, her grandpa died, or technically her dad. Her Dr. Noramaki died.
Oh, my God.
And we're sitting around, like, we want to be sad about this and really feel, you know, yeah, something, but we can't let it sit because, right, we have to keep on going.
Yeah.
And we find out she's a clone, and we're like, can we let that sit? No, keep on going.
Yeah.
And it's like, guys,
we have to escape this mansion of death.
Yeah. Like, I can't imagine any movie that they reveal something that big.
Right.
And it's like, just keep revving things up. We're, yeah, fine. And I'm like, no, being a clone is kind of a big deal. Not a, yeah, big stretch because, right, there's fucking dinosaurs. I've suspended my disbelief enough that you, right, could tell me that some of these dinosaurs have genes from space and it'd be like, I'm in. I don't give a fuck.
Space Godzilla.
Yeah, right. Oh, when there was the giant arm going in to pick up the bone for...
Right, the Indominus.
Yeah,
at the bottom.
I was like, it's like Mecha Godzilla coming in, and
right.
Was that when, or was it another?
Yeah,
part?
No, yeah, that was it. Yeah.
Because it's just because Godzilla got this, and I can't remember his name. Anduron.
What?
The actual dinosaur that died in the first one. The Indominus. There we go.
Oh yeah,
I already,
yeah,
forgot its name.
Right.
The Indominus. I love that the Indominus, like, it died via an oxygen bomb, and it's actually currently at the bottom of the bay.
Yeah, that was odd. Like, I mean...
What do you mean?
No,
you think, like, it would have decomposed like that?
No. Like, the Mosasaur that eats it in the first movie, like...
Technically didn't eat it. It dragged it down.
Dragged it down, but it would have... It would have eaten.
Okay.
Mosasaur will eat anything it can get its mouth on.
Does it not poop bones? Or?
Well, that's the thing. I feel like it would have... The skeleton wouldn't have survived that intact. It would have been digested, or at least broken.
Yeah, I think they made it because for the movie,
right,
they wanted to make it look like it was intact, like it was picked apart, but,
yeah,
it wasn't. It was consumed by a very large whale type beast.
Yeah. Well, reptile, but
yeah. I mean,
size of a whale.
Yeah, yeah, it's like a, yeah, whelmer. It looked like the whelmer or whale lord.
Yeah.
Yeah,
no, Mosasaur can get huge.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe not to the size of whales, but...
Oh, here's something that's stupid.
But big.
end of the movie.
I may have to revisit that, but...
End of the movie.
Yes.
When they're showing all the dinosaurs coexisting with people, potentially ready to ruin their day. Why was there a mosasaur in the water?
Because it escaped from the beginning. They left the...
That's fine.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying, the reason why is they made it seem like when they let everything out of the lab, there was just a flapping mobasaur like a Magikarp just coming out of the lab when they let everything go. Yeah. No, that's from the island because it's seabound. So it's like, I'm going to get the fuck out of here.
Because they had the lagoon closed off. Like, it was kind of like how they do with the first movies. It's like, stay the fuck away from this island. Right. It is closed off, quarantined. Mm-hmm. Like, do not get near. Like, the government will shoot you on sight if you get close to this island.
Okay. But yes, that's fair. Speaking of more bullshit, I think they should have, or they could have, gone without, and I don't know what cataclysmic event they would have chosen, but I think they could have gone without the volcanic eruption.
Okay.
Or, well...
I mean, it's funny. I was trying to think of... I don't remember my geology as much as I'd like to, but I was looking at where Isla Nublar is, and I'm like, would it be volcanic? I'm like, if there's a fault there that would make, or a hotspot. I'm guessing it would be a hotspot island chain.
I wasn't even trying to get that into it.
Yeah.
I was trying to say, like, from what I've heard, because I definitely know my geology less than you, way less, super less. But what I know is that volcanoes are notoriously hot. Who the fuck knew? And so the only time I could ever see someone standing anywhere near a volcano and not, now that I know that, like, not just hot, but like even being near the open part of the volcano where, you know, there's lava around, you can only be Broly. Or JoJo, or someone of the JoJo line.
That's fair.
That is the only two times, and those are both Japanese animated shows. They're both anime.
Yeah,
that makes sense. And even then, quote unquote, making sense in the Broly movie, that was their plan: throw him into the lava,
right?
Because dear God, it's lava. But still, when looking at this movie, it's like, guys, you're on the island while it's erupting.
Yeah,
y'all should have been dead so many times over. And believe me, I'm a big suspension of disbelief kind of guy. I really am. Again, we have to accept something, you know, certain things in this world that we're watching because dinosaurs exist.
Right.
But, and also another thing too, I also understand that, you know, from the last movie, like, there were some close calls that people got out of. I mean, even if you don't want to call them close calls, because in some cases I don't want to call them that, but, like, obviously having her run in heels away from a T-Rex, I during our first podcast, I looked at you and I was like, are you sure?
Yeah.
And you were like, probably not, but...
Right? Yeah.
Well, she would get eaten. That would have been terrible. But my point, though, is that in this movie, not only where I think there were too many close calls, where too many times where I was like, really? That person lived? I'm not saying I didn't want her to die, but I'm like, that person lived?
Right.
And more importantly, that entire scene on the island definitely should have involved... It should have ended with someone's death.
Yeah.
Really bad if it ended in Owens, because that would be weird.
Right.
But...
Yeah.
It should have ended in someone's death, and the fact that everybody survived
yeah.
and then went on to do more things in the movie, the fact that that wasn't... Didn't you think that was going to be the end of the movie?
Yeah, it's weird. Like, I really didn't know how they were going to... Mm-hmm. Because, like you said, from the trailers, it was kind of... Like, it was good in a sense that the trailers did not reveal too much about the plot of the movie. So they still had those action scenes where it's like, oh, this is going to look cool, but, like, you didn't really glimpse... the full aspect of what the plot was going to be.
Thank God.
Yeah, which, right, it's... For this, I'm glad that it didn't do that, because... I mean, I feel like if they had showed a little bit more of maybe the dinosaurs being taken off the island, because it kind of has that feel from the second Jurassic Park movie, like, Lost World. Jurassic Park, Lost World.
Every time you say Jurassic Park, Lost World, I'm like, no, but this is the world. No, Matt, this is Jurassic World. Yeah. My brain completely fucks that up every single time.
It's basically InGen taking the dinos back to a site back in, guess where, too? California.
But you know what? I think I preferred this one somehow more, in a way, because it makes sense that you would take them just to sell them underground.
Right.
Even though it's a shitty thing.
Yeah.
Versus saying... T-Rexes in LA. What can go wrong?
Am I right?
What's going wrong is the fact that you were born, you fucking idiot. Jesus Christ, you're gonna doom us all to a fiery death.
I'm pretty sure Hammond and Malcolm said that to that, said along those lines to that character at least once or twice within that movie.
Yeah, pretty much, because it's just true. Just yeah. What the fuck are you doing?
Yeah, so I remember what you didn't like about the lava was Owen gets betrayed when they go find Blue, and the dude just upright shoots him with the tranquilizer dart, which didn't see that coming. And Owen is like numb and realizes, I need to get out of here.
Yes.
And then the lava is creeping towards him, and you're like, shouldn't he be burning right now?
And yeah, that's what I said. And did you, I felt like you disagreed, but you did, no, you disagreed to him being dead.
Yeah.
But you said that he should be burning, because I thought he would be dead.
He would get severe burns.
Yeah.
But the lava, because like, if you think in Hawaii, which is actually going through its own eruptions right now, and
right.
That's.
Yeah, we don't talk about that right now. Yeah,
that's a whole nother situation. Yeah. That's real life story. Yeah, that's real life. But yeah. So, the type of lava that was going across the ground is weird, because that's a different kind of volcano. That okay. Lava probably shouldn't have come from that kind of volcano.
God damn it, I love having you on this show, yeah. Tristan.
Like, that's, I believe it's what the scientific name is, a lahar.
Mm-hmm.
I believe that's the right term. I could be wrong. It's been a while.
All right, I think, what was it, lahar?
It's slow, yeah.
Yeah, you just call me a Spanish whore.
What?
Lahar. Lahore. Oh. It's like Lahore. And I'm like, how okay. Dare you, sir? Like, I am not Lahore.
What?
I am.
So the lava that's coming towards him is cooling off as it's flowing across the land, but it's still, obviously, it's still lava. Mm-hmm. It's still incredibly hot. Usually, volcanologists will have a heat-resistant suit on to get close. So you can get close to that lava. You still can't touch it, but you can actually get close to it and be okay.
Yes.
Especially with it being as slow moving as it is. Granted, you're not half numb when it's coming towards you. But right. Yeah, I agree. Without a heat suit, yes, he probably would have been in severe pain.
And the funny thing is, I'm not even saying he needs to be in severe pain, but you mentioned burns. His yeah. Body doesn't show any...
No. Like, his clothing may have actually burst into flame. That, I would agree. Like, yeah.
My God. Now, yeah. Granted, I'm not asking for super duper duper realism, because of right. Course he would have died in the first movie.
Right.
Yeah. You know, he's the character is a Navy SEAL.
Yeah.
That doesn't mean that you're trained to go up against dinosaurs.
Right.
Now, he trained with dinosaurs, but even yeah. Then, he trained with raptors, not with T-Rexes. Right. If he raised T-Rexes, I'd be like, oh, damn, this dude is fucking dope.
Right.
scientifically, in terms of being
the Dino Whisperer.
He would be the Dino Whisperer, yeah, pretty Which much.
He pretty much is.
He is, but only for raptors. He's the Raptor yeah. Whisperer.
I mean, like, you could argue that raptors, they have that social hierarchy, so, like, you can have that communication with them, at least as, like, establishing yourself as a pack leader. Like, you know, like they show, he's been with them since birth.
So yeah, T-Rex. Yeah, T-Rex would be like...
T-Rex is a bit more of a loner. It's a bit more difficult.
I'm happy that I know you, but I still kind... You know what? Yeah, I'm going to eat your face.
Yeah.
But I mean, it was really nice when we knew each other when we weren't doing that.
Right. But I'm hungry and you're the nearest thing.
Yeah, so. Let me just eat your face.
Yeah. You're not another dinosaur, so I can kind of do it easily, so...
But I feel like it wouldn't be enough food for no. Them.
It would be a snack. That's, it's like when he eats the goat every time.
That made me sad.
Yeah.
Also, because...
That poor goat.
Yeah. The reason why it made me sadder, I think, is because you and I had saw a trailer before that for The Grinch, the new animated Grinch. So I thought the goat was going to yell, and I was going to be... At least that would have been funny in a sad way.
Oh, my God.
But it was just a baby goat going, bah! And I'm yeah. Like, no! Yeah. Goat! Go! Ooh. I was like, the goat should go blue on that T-Rex.
Oh, my God.
But
one thing before we switch, the thing that bothered me though about the volcanic eruption,
okay,
was what you do see in the trailer is the pyroclastic flow. So that giant ash cloud, the giant smoke cloud that follows Pratt as he's running away, and the other two are in the gyrosphere and they fall off the cliff.
It's not just car exhaust.
No, I mean,
maybe
yeah,
it was made that,
that
way.
That is superheated rock and ash. That cloud touches you, you die. The heat, you would die.
What do you mean by die? Not disintegrate.
Not disintegrate, but probably, like, I'm guessing, like, thinking burst into flame, you would asphyxiate. very quickly.
So you're telling me that basically, if it hit the back of his back of his wonderful outfit, that amazing outfit,
he'd start
I would say it would stick to his skin, and when they ripped it off him, his skin would be ripped off with it, if not meat.
Yeah. Okay. And I guess the, okay, I know enough to be like, I know he would die from it, the exact way he would die from it, I'm not sure, but I would venture the guess to be, the first thing would be, your lungs would be gone. You'd asphyxiate, because the heat would just tear your organs apart.
Right.
Never mind the dust and rock particles in the air.
Right.
But so yeah, it's, so it's you that could Hollywood consider magic it. Of like, I'm going to outrun the, you know, earthquake or like stuff like that. It's like, no, you're dead.
But before it actually hits him, he can outrun it or even being that close.
Oh, that, thing, so that being... stuff is going thousands of miles an hour.
From the
explosion.
Okay.
That it doesn't work like, oh, it's creeping up behind me. No, that would envelop you. There is no way you could outrun that.
No, what I meant was, I wasn't even talking about it that way, but thank you for telling me that. I meant it more so of outrunning as in, if he is somehow ahead of it, it's not going to burn him until it hits him.
No, you'd need to be miles away to get away from it in time.
I'm saying, let's say you are miles away.
Oh, okay.
It's not gonna burn him. It's gonna burn him by being hitting him physically, not behind him.
No.
Okay. It's once the cloud envelops him, you're gone. Fucked.
Yes. Right. There is no way.
And it looked like it was going to. It looked like it enveloped him.
It did envelop him for a few seconds.
I would consider that a continuity error, but maybe it was also just like you said. You know,
even
those
few seconds, he.
Oh no, he'd be dead. No, he'd be dead. Because he jumped, but.
Right. Which, it's funny, you see the gyrosphere with Claire and the other guy, Kevin, I think was his name?
Yes.
Maybe? He was the tech guy who helped them get into the compound to find, because they were, tracking the dinosaurs through radio signals. But they both fall in the gyrosphere, and you see the dinosaurs. That was the saddest thing for me, even in the trailer, too, just the dinos, like, trying to swim. It's like, no, these guys can't. It's like an ankylosaur, like, flailing his little legs, and I'm like, no.
Yeah, I have to admit, the movie did a good job while watching the movie. It did a great job of making me feel sad for the dinosaurs, because, of course, I'm not advocating for their death.
Right. Oh, it was even worse, like, once they all make it off. I don't think you even see Owen jump off the cliff. He just appears in the water to help them break out. But after they get on the truck and leave on the boat, the brachiosaur, that's the only thing left on the dock, is just enveloped in the cloud.
Yeah.
And you just see it die and, like, basically screaming as you see the cloud go over.
We're going to keep the phone in this unless... Yep. Nope. Didn't pick it up yet. I'm loving this. And now we're back. That was beautiful. But, question though, I mentioned earlier I'm not advocating for them to die,
right?
Because I'm not, like, I'm not saying we should go over there and murder them all ourselves. It's a little rough, right? It's a little rough, but I do have a question for you though, and I do feel like we should open this up also to you guys in the comment section below. Do you think, Tristan, that we should have meddled in this affair? I know you love dinosaurs, but do you think we should have meddled in this affair? Now, they didn't ask to be born.
No. Yeah.
But we made them not to even fit into the ecosystem.
Right, back into the natural order of things in which they once existed.
Yeah,
this
is
on an isolated island.
Yes.
Yeah.
What's your take on it?
Because they try, like, they bring in the idea of they're endangered. They're, you know, once they're gone again, which... Really, I mean, I guess because the company's gone, they can't clone more. Because it's kind of like, we really shouldn't be.
You have Goldblum in this, but you're acting like the first three didn't exist.
Right, yeah.
Right.
It's, like, if they were able to follow the other guys, it was Wood something, the last name. The other guy who worked with Hammond.
Mm-hmm. He was, the grandpa.
The grandfather, if they had followed that plan, like he had wanted, bring the dinosaurs to another island, a sanctuary, let them live in peace, no tourism, just leave them live out their lives on the island. Sure. I'd say if you can save some of them from the island that's going to explode.
Okay.
Sure. But in the sense of it's either we save them and they escape out into the real world, or we let them die on this island... for the sake of people not being completely destroyed and, you know, the food chain being rewritten.
Yeah.
Yes, I would have to say you have to leave them on the island.
Okay, because I felt like...
Even though it would pain me to do that.
No, and it pains me too because, you know, you and I both believe in wildlife preservation.
Yeah.
And the reason why we do is because we understand that technically capitalism, but I would argue mostly corporations that are involved in capitalism,
yeah,
are destroying the environment.
Yeah.
And I've been doing this for years to the point where we've had media discussing the environment being polluted throughout the last 40, 50 years.
And mass extinction events, too.
Yeah, it's not fucking new. I mean, globally. Bees, certain types of bees,
yeah,
and a bunch of other things. And I'm not sitting here and saying, oh, we should just let it die. That's the natural order. No. We're fucking up the natural order.
Yeah.
But in this case, us fucking up the natural order isn't killing them. It's bringing them back.
Right.
To life. And yes, we've already opened up that box.
Gate, yeah.
We've already opened up that gate. That's already been mentioned. But that was mentioned more so when we've already opened up the gate, and that's why bad guys want to use that as an example.
Right.
Not, we've already opened up the gate, so what are we going to do? Murder them? And I'm like, no, we shouldn't murder them.
Right.
If the movie was about a company saying we have to go on that island and shoot down every last one of them,
yeah,
you and I would both be like, no,
right.
Owen,
why?
Save the day.
Right, yeah.
But because... And you could say maybe it's a bit more nuanced in this way and it's a bit better. That's kind of why I might like this movie in a way, a little bit more than the first in a way.
Yeah.
There's a bit more nuance to it. But at the same time, I don't like that. I feel as if I'm trying to be led to an opinion that even someone like me who's a bleeding heart is kind of like, but guys,
right,
a T-Rex is not equivalent to a lion.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, lions don't exist in the forest.
Yeah.
I love that so much. That was such a good line.
Right.
I know, I looked at you and you were chuckling. I was like, of course you would be. But no, that's just my take on it. Like, I believe that everything deserves life. But again, I'm not... Like, I believe it deserves life. Like, I'm not going to go out and kill it.
Right.
Yeah. Now, granted, I'm not trying to go the Batman approach where, like, you know, I'm not going to save you. I don't want to be shitty Batman approach here. You know, like, I didn't murder him. Batman, you broke his legs. Yeah, and he didn't die. And his spine. Yeah, he's still alive. In a wheelchair. So, is he still committing crimes? Oh, jeez. Batman, you asshole.
That's my name to word up.
I don't know. I just imagine like a Batman, what's like, not fog, not smoke machine, smoke bomb.
Smoke bomb, yeah.
Bat bomb. But no, I'm just saying that, like, it felt odd to me because, again, I'm super bleeding heart. I'm not sitting here like, oh, bees are dying. So what? I can get an iPhone. Like, no, those two shouldn't. Like, we shouldn't be looking at animals like, oh, who cares? Also, I will admit, I'm not a vegetarian. So fuck me there.
No,
right? To be fair.
Yeah, no.
Fuck
same,
me there. So, yeah, so you can call me an asshole in that regard. Totally cool with it. But I'm just trying to say that. I can understand that there is a pecking order,
right,
and it's not about us being pushed off. Although you can say, hey, I'm being selfish because it's about us being pushed off the pecking order.
Yeah.
But the thing is that it's being pushed off the pecking order when I would argue we don't need to be pushed off the pecking order if the dinosaurs were a little bit smarter. What I mean is you look at me and you're like, Matt, we're just snacks to them. So it's like, oh, then they'll just eat each other like they have been. Oh no, if they see us, they're going to want to eat us. And I'm like,
I mean, they wouldn't pass up the opportunity if it presented
but
itself.
I think if they could pass up the opportunity, then I'd be like, oh, I'm in no danger. It's just them eating them because, of course, it's more meat versus us where it's like, we're barely, we register as like one Cheeto. Honestly, come on.
Maybe
quite a little
bit more than that.
Right. Maybe like a small burrito.
Yeah, okay.
On the smaller side.
Sure.
It's just a small snack.
It's a panini.
It's a panini. Fucking love paninis. All right, so you know what? Fine, eat me, dinosaurs. If I am your panini... Hey, I'm Cuban. I'm Cuban, so that works. I will become your panini.
Yeah.
But still, you see what I mean, though? Like,
yeah.
And I hate it, too, because I feel like it turns people like you and I, who are like... We believe in the preservation.
Right.
But Malcolm wasn't... Like, why was Malcolm wrong?
Right.
Like, I'm sorry to say this, but, like, why was Malcolm wrong?
Wrong, yeah.
We made them... If a dinosaur randomly showed up out of nowhere, if there was, like,
that
a weird...
That would be different.
If there was a weird time rip and a dinosaur appeared out of a time rip,
right,
I'd be like, yo, it didn't ask to be here. We didn't make the rip,
right,
Doctor. And
I'm like, is he referencing the episode? I think he is.
No, actually, although that was a nice episode. Dinosaurs on a spaceship, right?
Also, Invasion of the Dinosaurs. That's the third Doctor.
Oh, I saw that one. They were ripped
out of time and space.
Yes,
yeah.
I like that one a lot, actually. Yeah. He was Earthbound in that one, right? Yeah, that was a good one. I love the miniatures they use for those dinosaurs. Yeah. They look really good, actually. But still, Doctor. We didn't make the rip in time. We didn't start the rip in. No, but the point is, I was just making up a random scenario. I wouldn't be like, we have to kill it, because what else can we do? I'd be like, no, it didn't ask to be here. Granted, neither did these, to be fair. But again, I assume the idea wouldn't be, if it came through a time rip, throw it on an island and we'll see what happens. No, this is nature. Like, I don't know, man. Like, it's so strange to me that, and I'm like, the idea of, oh, are we playing God? Right. I'm not trying to come at it from a religious point of view, because I don't like to have religion governing our government, because that's not what our government was made to do, for any religion to govern our government. Yeah. So I'm not trying to come at it from that, because one senator in the movie said, like, well, it's God's plan. And I was like, why did you have to say that? Because I agreed with you until you said that.
For the volcano to take out the island.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So I don't agree with that necessarily. However, I do think Malcolm was right. Like, hey, there's kind of a course correction coming.
Right.
Why are we going to... We played God once. So apparently, well, you know, if something wrong happens, and two wrongs make a right, apparently. Play God a second time and we'll be doing just fine. And I'm like...
No. Yeah.
Because I don't know. Like, to me, I consider that playing God.
Right.
Now, once they were moved... Then you could argue, well, should we let him go? That's a bit different.
Right? Yeah, playing that in the sense of bringing the dead back to life, basically.
Well, that was the first.
Yeah.
And then taking them off the island was the second.
Right.
But would you argue, I don't know if I would argue that the third was pushing the button at the end. I think it was wrong, but I don't know if I would argue it's playing God necessarily.
Yeah.
But because that wasn't man-made, that was someone being an asshole.
Right.
Well, no, actually, that was someone saving someone else's life.
The only way they could let the dinosaurs escape without being killed by toxic gas released in the...
Yeah. That's different, because that toxic gas wasn't, like, you know, made by some other, you know, whatever you want to call it. But I have a question for you. So I understand the little girl.
Yeah.
I understand her reasoning.
Right.
And it was
that's why it was good to see. Like, because Claire was like, I can't let them die.
Yeah.
I have to let them out. Like,
yes.
Because she's gone from that character of, I just look at them as assets.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, the bad guy of this movie kind of looks at her. It's like, how are you any different? It's like,
first of all, I am a woman. Okay, that's a difference. But how is it different in how you did things?
The idea
putting it in a cage and
making profit off of it.
Okay, you have red hair, you're a woman. What's the difference?
Their difference was keeping it contained in a park and not selling it on the black market to whoever wants it.
I have an odd feeling he kind of left that part out for good reason.
Oh, yeah, right.
For good reason.
Yeah.
He's just like, well, what's the difference between you and I?
Right.
One of us doesn't like the smell of their own shit, Tom.
Because I even said
First of all, it smells like lavender, Claire.
Right. Because even Owen goes like, Claire, once you do this, there's no going back. And she, like I even said to you, she opens the cages. Like, she doesn't even guess. Like, opens each and every cage. Then the last door to let them out completely, she's like, she hesitates. And I'm like, thank you.
Because
there should at least be some hesitation here on this one. This is a big choice.
Because it's a lot different than... Because in a way, it kind of harkens, speaking of Doctor Who, to that one episode of, are we going to torture this monster to help us stay as a civilization on its back?
Right, the space
whale. Or is it going to try to run away on us when we let it go because we've tortured it, or because we think it's a scary being? Yeah, a monster.
Right.
That's a lot different than a known predator that you've seen... Eat
people
multiple times and we're sitting back like, I mean, look, I'm not saying they don't have the right to live necessarily.
Right.
I'm just saying
the idea of releasing them out into California
is like, how first of all, in the first movie, Claire should have been charged with so many counts of manslaughter, but apparently no one gives a fuck for some reason. And now in this movie, are we gonna count her on manslaughter? No, no one. I'm so confused as to how laws work in this universe because we had Malcolm in a Senate hearing. Apparently, that's all they care about, hearings about things, but not actually putting people in jail.
Yeah.
So apparently, I don't think murder is all right. But manslaughter, A-okay in this universe, apparently. It didn't seem like it was okay early on with in the first three movies. Right, it seemed like in the first three movies with Hammond. Yeah. Thank you, with Hammond.
He got sacked like right away,
and he got sued by a fuck ton.
I mean, granted, they got sued. Like they made the mention of I think it was 8 million something or 80 somewhere in there. 80 million, 8 million. I know that's a big jump, but like. I'm paying reparations for people who were injured from the first one.
Oh, okay. I forgot about that. Wait, you mean in the parks or in Worlds movies?
In Worlds.
Okay.
In
the first because I forgot about that. Because the reason why I'm like throwing.
Yeah, no, like.
She's just allowed to be working with these little kids. And I know they're probably my age, but they look like they're younger.
Right.
These little kids who are able to lobby. Essentially, they're actually using cash, to be fair. But, they're able to talk to senators to try to campaign the idea that these dinosaurs should be preserved.
Right.
You made the mess. Could you imagine if I punched you in the nose, you're bleeding, and I'm like, oh, let me get you something to wipe that up. And I say, well, are you going to say thank you to me or not? Or, I'm expecting a thank you. It's like... You fucking started the mess.
Right, yeah.
And now you're going to be like, well, I'm actually going to... Actually, fuck, you're not even cleaning up your mess. You're continuing it. I'm continuously punching you in the face, and I'm like, hello, Senator, can we make this legal?
Oh, God.
I just don't understand. Again, I understand that things should live. I'm not saying things should not live.
Yeah.
It's just that this movie's message really gets convoluted when they're dinosaurs.
Right.
If they are anything but dinosaurs, also just not things that we made.
Yeah.
And also, to be fair, with the little girl at the end, I understand her message, and it's definitely a heartfelt one.
Life is living.
They are like me.
They were cloned, yeah, just like she was.
Well, guess what? Does she have part raptor DNA? Because if she does...
I'm still waiting.
Me too, I am.
Because guess what, dude? I wouldn't put it past
If she has part raptor DNA or any dinosaur DNA in her, then the conversation gets started.
Right.
And the example is made firmly.
Right.
But before she talks about having dinosaur blood running through her veins...
Because honestly, I feel like if she's kept around, I feel like she's going to be like... She's going to learn from Owen.
I hope so.
She's going to be, talking to raptors. Not talking, but, you know, the clicking.
Oh, my God, you have raptors.
Speak raptor?
That's terrifying. But no, what I'm saying is that, if she had that in her body, I know it might sound silly, but if she did, that would make more sense because you are a child. Right. The amount of people
you're the bridge between the species.
The amount of people that she could kill at any point in her life versus dinosaurs.
Right.
If there was one dinosaur and one of her, at least that's something. There are dozens of dinosaurs that were let out versus one of her.
Right.
Again, I get what the message is trying to do. I just think that it was a bit too simplified and didn't want us to think about the fact that they are killing machines.
Right.
Not all of them. The herbivores, I would chill out with a herbivore. But guess what? Herbivore would be like, how's it going, bud? And stomp on me.
Right.
Because he's like, aw, dude.
Because I think of herbivores, honestly, I thought of it for the longest time the same way. It's like, oh, why can't we just have a Jurassic Park, but with herbivores? It's like, well, you have a circus with elephants, and we see that's not legal anymore because big animals don't do well in confined spaces.
Yeah, yeah.
Even if they are not meat-eating.
Even putting aside the... Also, another thing, too. Even putting aside... I don't know. Just in general... I mean, granted, yes, it was never to put them in captivity... with the newest plan. It was actually a plan of peace, which is true. But so I don't know, man. I just feel like...
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. Also, I hate to say this because I'm going to sound like a complete dick.
Okay.
But, because the thing is...
Wouldn't be the first time. Ha ha.
But the thing is, you didn't see me pause. He just saw me just pause stone face. No, but my thing is this, right? In the future... if there are clones, right, I'm not going to sit there and be like clones of people. Be like, get away from me. You're not real. No, I can, you know, I can hang with them. I could maybe love them. I could maybe lay with them. Like, I'm not going to sit here and be like, you're a clone. Get away from me, you scum. But I do feel odd that a clone gets to speak for the human race on how many dinosaurs are going to fucking murder people. That's a big thing to... That's kind of why, speaking of... I don't know why I keep on bringing up Doctor Who. The Doctor was... The Doctor...
Those big choices.
The Doctor, in many situations, when it involves saving people, but it's kind of a human issue.
Right.
He lets the humans decide.
Right.
Now, granted, in other cases, when it's like there's giant aliens coming down, yeah, of course he's going to be like, I don't want to let the humans decide. I'm going to save you,
right,
because you want to be saved. Right. But when it comes to an actual choice being made,
right,
recently within the last...
That won't explode their entire planet.
Recently within the last 10 years, if there's a big choice to be made, he goes, right, well, you know, if you want to say that you represent humanity, you make the choice.
Right.
In this case, it's someone who does not represent all of every... Granted, not one... There isn't one person, whoever it is. Doesn't matter who, right, it is. Is it your leader? There's not one person, I don't care, right, who, that represents every single human being.
Yeah.
To be fair. And I feel like that's kind of what Claire was thinking as well. Again, like, I am not God.
Right.
And yeah, sure, she didn't think of... The little girl didn't think of herself as God in this case. She thought of herself as one of the people who could be dying, right, in a situation like... Or one of the beings that could be dying in a situation, yeah, like this. But it just, I don't know, it just came off as like, you're making a big decision.
Yeah. I mean, also a child as well.
Even worse. In terms of, it's funny, I have no problem, Tristan usually has a problem with child characters when we watch movies.
Oh, I love this character.
Me too. I loved her too.
Yeah.
Up until that moment.
Right.
And I'm just like, right, you're a child who, normally I'm not sitting here like, oh, stupid child.
Right.
But which this is
the ramifications, like the
are huge.
Huge, right? Exactly.
Like, my
and
God.
Like she might get the idea, like this is gonna be rough, but not really thinking the whole idea. It's like we've released predators, like, you know, a Tyrannosaurus.
She's lived
a Carnosaur, an Allosaur.
She's lived with dinosaurs, right, in her fucking mansion. Her entire goddamn life. You think, right, it's the fucking carnival.
Right. And she also saw the video with Owen, you know, talking with Blue and all the other raptors when they were tiny. Like, yeah, we can communicate with them. It's like, that was a very specific and, you know, certain situation where that worked out.
Now, to be fair.
And that worked out much better than they ever thought it would.
Now, to be fair, if they shit on that decision in the third movie, then I'm good.
Yeah.
Because that was what I imagine would the point be. Right. Shit on it at that point. Okay. Well, shit on that point.
Right. Yeah.
But it's when you don't do that. If they try to be like, and this is a good thing, and we'll try to see what we can make out of it.
Right.
No, you did a really fucked up thing, kid.
Yeah. Yeah. It is just a large choice that was made very quickly.
Yeah. And it's one of those things because, like, I'm cool with, like, action movies having depth or yada yada.
Yeah.
But I think it was just a depth that I'm not saying, like, I'm not against it.
Yeah.
It's just that I don't think it was too, like, it was one of those, like, oh, we're going to have some depth, but it couldn't be maybe too deep.
Right.
So yeah, it just seems very surface level. And it's like,
yeah,
anyone who thinks about it for 5 minutes,
yeah,
including, I'm sure, the director, I'm not saying that they didn't think about it. I'm not trying to say it's brainless, right?
Right, right.
I'm sure they thought about it. And believe me, I love their pro-environmental message.
Yeah.
No doubt. 100%.
Right.
It's just, I don't know. Like, there are certain, like, because there's certain messages
there
in Star Wars, right?
Yeah.
Where, like, droids, mm-hmm, are just like everyone else. In fact, they are an oppressed class. I agree with that notion. So what happened in Solo, that whole like talk about that, didn't, mm-hmm, really make me feel upset, because whenever I watch episode 4, I'm like, oh God, that's how they treat the droids?
Yeah. Right.
Oh yeah, they can't come in this bar. And I'm like, fuck you, buddy.
Right.
But they had to do business. And they're like, all right, yeah, I have to do business. Sorry, guys, right, you wait outside. But it seemed like a dick move.
Yeah.
So for me personally, I have no problem with that, with, you know, making that connection to, you know, if you want to, you know, they made the droid give her a woman's voice,
right,
if you will, right? I use quote air quotes, you know, woman's voice. So in that case, they made it, you know, people were thinking like, oh, it's like the feminism and stuff like that. But again, like, yeah, I can understand the connection though, because while women, I would argue, aren't 100% always oppressed, there is still a patriarchy, right? So in this case, Tristan nodded for all of you out there that are taking... No, I'm kidding.
Yeah, yeah. Well,
I'm kidding.
No,
I'm kidding.
Yeah.
I'm fucking with you. I'm fucking with you. I'm fucking with you. Just no, because it's just making fun of those people that are like, they're always watching and, you know, just they got to make sure unless, you know, they're gonna come after us, those SJWs. I'm making fun of that
right.
aspect.
Right,
but yeah. I make fun of it. But what I'm trying to get at, though, is it's still very hard to be like, see, it's like... You know, the bees that died. And it's like, no, it's not. A bee could sting me. A bee isn't a T-Rex. If the bees were the size of T-Rexes, we'll talk.
I mean, if they were... Oh, God.
Well, a lot of bees, of course.
I don't want to live on this planet.
I know, if there were that many bees trying to hurt you. What I'm trying to say is,
yeah,
is that,
no.
like...
I mean, I was going to say, like, killer bees, like a swarm of them will kill you very easily.
Right. But they were...
eat you, but...
But here's the thing. What I'm saying is looking at how many dinosaurs were released at the end there. Right. If there were that many amount of bees, killer or otherwise...
Right. Yeah.
That's
okay.
not
I,
a...
I see what you mean.
That's what I'm saying. Like, there's just one dinosaur, and it's not even... It sounds like shitty propaganda, but it's just the truth. One dinosaur could eat, if it wanted to, an entire town. It could murder... All of you guys.
Yeah.
You'd have to be in an underground bunker to survive one T-Rex. And even then, if it can sniff you out. I mean, it can't get through the metal.
Yeah, it's not going to get through the metal. I would argue, even staying indoors, if the buildings are, like, reinforced, I'd say you'd be safe indoors. But, yeah. It would be, like, mandatory. It would be, like... curfews and it would be there would have to be an alarm system like we have a T-Rex sighting, get indoors.
I would say curfew is funny because the T-Rex is just like, I don't really like going out during the day, but more so like the alarms are the curfew is if you can't see a T-Rex, stay inside.
Right,
dick.
Exactly. Yeah.
but
or
yes,
even
so
the
like,
raptor even
oh like, the raptors are worse arguably because they can, they're sneaky little shits. I would argue raptors are worse than T-Rexes because you can see a T-Rex coming. Sure, the T-Rex can outrun you, but you can see it.
See it, yeah.
But anyway, or at least hear it. Sorry, that's better. You can hear it. But yeah, so when looking at this movie, did I hate it? No. Do I like its message? As an in general thing, I think. I love this message, you know? Right. It's just one of those things where it's a bit hard when...
You really start to think about it.
When you really start to think about it because... It's just they're not cuddly little creatures.
Right.
And, of course, even the ones that are cuddly little creatures, we already discussed, they could accidentally kill you.
Right.
And it's not just a simple, oh, I accidentally hurt you.
Right.
If that one dinosaur, the one that was really cute and was licking Owen's face while, while he was paralyzed, what was it called?
The
dinosaur?
Compsognathus.
Okay, cool, that one.
Yeah.
Compi could have stomped his arm off. I thought he did. I thought he decapitated because when he stepped.
Oh, the one that licked him. Right. That was a. It might have been a Monoclonius?
Right. So, like, when.
It was
Monty,
a Ceratopsian.
So what? Oh, so when Sari was licking him, I'm
there
sitting there. Monty or Sari? When Sari was licking him, when he stepped down, I thought
he took his arm off. Yeah.
Which can happen.
Right. Exactly.
Wow. How?
Right.
Frankly. And I don't know if Callie is very well equipped for dinosaurs.
I don't think anywhere is very well equipped for dinosaurs.
I feel like there are some deserts if they want to live in the desert.
I mean, we've still got the...
Some can. There are some forests.
Oh, well... Wait,
I'm not talking about major cities that are equipped to hold dinosaurs. I mean, like, there are some areas in the U.S.
that have
big enough open spaces for dinosaurs.
Oh, okay.
But they're not going to want to... I don't think the dinosaurs are going to be like, you know what, you're right. You stay over there, I'll stay over here.
Right, fair. I mean, we saw that with the Mosasaur in the ocean. Oh, that was terrifying.
It was, yeah.
Like, you think shark attacks would be bad.
Ah, Jesus,
Wait for a Mosasaur.
But to be fair, again, that one wasn't her fault, so I can't blame her for that.
And granted, it's like you are in their environment, too.
See, that one is blaming just them for making it. I can't blame her for that, because she didn't. The button that she pushed, the little girl, didn't open up on the island.
Right,
yeah,
right.
I think escaped from the island.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I think... this movie overall, it was a fun experience. I don't know what I'd give it. I'd give it 3 out of 5 Endoraptors.
Endoraptors.
3 out of 5 Endoraptors.
Okay.
I don't know if it's... Because I don't think it's a 4.5. I don't think it's anywhere close to perfection. But it's better than the first one in many ways. Because I think them going in depth with his with Owen's history with Blue,
yeah,
was that something was nice. That, well, because in the first movie they only make a few references and do shit with it. And I mean jack shit.
Right.
They're just like, yeah, they're friends. And I'm like, can you show me something? And then they showed the clip in the trailer, and then sure, we're seeing it in a weird roundabout way through the girl's eyes, but at least we're seeing, and also we, to be fair, Owen saw some of the clips too.
Yeah, yeah.
But we're seeing the clips, and I'm like, yes, this is great. Also, I think it's, I'm super happy that Owen and Claire weren't together in the beginning, because it was such weak sauce at the end of the first movie that it would be really odd if they were a married couple with a kid.
Right. That's, you were laughing at the joke they made between each other.
Oh, the whole, it's like
I left you. No. I left you.
Well, because when she was laughing, I was like, see, like, again, I see them as friends who share laughs. And she goes, you think you left me? And I'm like, and even the theater was like, there was, there weren't a lot of people in that theater, but they were like,
there were a few, at least a few people. Yeah.
Well, no, I think there were like less than 20, which in a big theater like that, we're in an AMC theater in, you know, Penn Station.
Fair.
But no, but I'm saying it's funny to me because of the fact that, like, out of all those people, there was a majority of,
right.
It wasn't super loud, but it was loud enough that you can hear it coming in. I was
It was audible.
Yeah. Also, people yelling or hearing women in the back or behind me, at least a few rows behind, left and right. I'm hearing that it's hard to hear because there's a lot of sound going on screen. You know, T-Rex, people running from T-Rexes, the soundtrack. But you can just hear. You can just hear whisperings of, in heels? And I'm like, yeah, well, because they're seeing her run in heels and they're like, all right, I'm mad that she's running in heels in that dirt against the T-Rex. It was beautiful having women, like hearing women get that riled up where like, yeah, when I wear heels, you know. But anyway, so it was just funny to me.
Yeah.
And, but yeah, so I think this movie may have been better than the first one.
Okay.
In some ways. But again, the message was a little wonky.
Right.
The ending I'm not a big fan of because you didn't have to have them get loose.
Right.
You could have easily just, I mean, again, we're seeing other organizations, they still made off with the loot.
Yeah.
At least with the
that
tubes.
Was the actual terrifying part.
Yeah.
Cuz like
to me, yeah.
Right, cuz you see like they have another hearing with Jeff Goldblum or Malcolm.
No, I think
talking.
It's the same one. I think they just cut it in between.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah, I think they did that.
Because the first one was about the island, and then the second, I feel like they had another
No, they're just asking him general questions in a hearing. Okay. You can ask them any questions about the island and the dinosaurs.
Oh,
I assume
right,
there was
right,
just
right.
one,
You're right.
but they split up it
okay.
split it up into two because
You're right.
in the that's the thing, they showed I think they showed at least a little bit of every single Jeff Goldblum moment, as in like the full scene.
Right,
I think they showed every single one in the trailer.
Yeah, yeah.
Making me believe that Goldblum would be part of the fucking island.
Right.
I mean, granted, I didn't expect him to be running.
Yeah, yeah.
But like, I'm sure he can run.
Well,
he seems like he's fit, but I still don't want him running.
Yeah.
it's like Ford. Can Ford crash a plane and be okay? Yes. Am I advising it happen? No.
I mean, that's the big thing with, like, a lot of the returning characters. It's like, they always make the deal. It's like, I would never go back there. There is no force on the face of this planet that would make me go back to that island. Except this.
Terrible Malcolm impression. That sentence was under a minute. Terrible Malcolm impression.
I mean, well, because, like...
I know, you're saying it in general.
Yeah. It's like, Owen was like, no, I'm not going back. Blue's on the island. Even he was like, Jesus Christ, Claire, really?
You know, that was some emotional manipulative bullshit. That's kind of why I'm happy that they don't date.
Yeah.
Because that was some... Like, she's still using the fact that it's like, you care about him, don't you? That'll get me something.
Well,
that I mean, don't like, want... Yeah. And granted, something that she would get is to save these animals.
Right. I mean, she was also saying, it's like, come on, I know you're not that heartless. And he's like, I'm also not insane.
But it still feels like emotional manipulation.
Oh yeah,
you know?
Yeah. But, like, just that she said it, like, so direct and deadpan.
Yeah.
And, like, she's like, Blue's still alive. And he's like,
fuck you.
Wow. You could have bought dinner. Gee.
Yeah, right? I loved... another thing, too, by the way. I have no problem with the nephews not being shown.
Mm.
But, man, were they not even mentioned.
Yeah.
Like, you would think Owen...
They only mentioned him, and like obviously because he's not around in the movies, but like,
and also he was at least they showed a picture of him.
Yeah, that's true. Like, the portrait on the wall, that was a nice touch.
Like you, like they're at the bar. You wouldn't, you know, how are the kids? Right. Oh, they're doing fine. Sadly, you know, mom and dad divorced, but the kids are doing okay, and honestly, they're a lot closer than they used to be. That's sweet. Now, why am I here?
Right.
Like, I wonder if that was part of the movie and they cut it out during the... Because it sounds like something that would they would say at the bar.
Yeah, that would be a line,
just a small mention. Like, shit. Like, these characters... I'm not saying I want them to, you know, have a... I don't want... Just, like, the littlest one, just... I am going to run Engine now.
Oh, no.
He's, like, the big baddie in the third.
Oh, God.
I don't fucking care. I don't want that.
Yeah.
But I care enough that, like, they were a big part. And really seeing the first movie, it felt like Owen kind of grew attached to those kids in a way. Which, funnily enough, you would think, like, that would be... If the movie was written differently, that would be his and also Claire's way of going, you know what? I'm okay with kids in the future.
Right,
Looks at each other. Winks.
Yeah.
But no, they were not together. And again... fine with it. It was super real.
Right. Yeah.
But yeah, as we're wrapping this thing up, is there anything that maybe you wanted to happen in this movie that didn't happen? Do you think everything that...
No, I mean, I was, like I said, I really didn't have much to go on going into the movie. Mm-hmm. So I was like, okay, what's going to go on? And I honestly, like, other than the ramifications of thinking about the decision that was made to release them into, you know, human populations, I think it's going to be, it's a really cool concept to explore for the next movie.
Yeah, I'm,
like, that's going to be interesting.
Yeah, the movie,
I'm hyped.
Yes, the movie made me less hyped than the trailer did, but that's because the trailer made me so hyped.
Right.
Yeah. So I don't think that's a detriment to the movie. It's just because of the fact that when you see Jeff Goldblum coming back, well, because I didn't think he'd ever show up again.
Right.
That I thought this was going to be, I thought this was just be, you know, just going to be three new movies and that's
it. He was pretty vocal, like, going back to Lost World, like, he was pretty vocal about what happened in the first movie. Like, he tried to get it out there and people just called him crazy.
Right.
So, like, seeing him back now, it's like, oh, that makes sense. He's like, I have experience.
Is there anyone here who has an objection? Well, you know, actually, I do. It's like, well, that's the guy that does.
You just see him walk into the courtroom.
Backwards. And while pointing at every woman in the place.
Oh, God.
Yeah, so I have no problem with him appearing. Again, that made me hyped. I felt like maybe we had a little bit too little time on the island. Again, even though I'm happy they didn't show much of the bad guys, it made it seem like the big issue was a cataclysmic event. Like, I do kind of feel lied to, in a way.
Right.
Because, like, we never saw bad guys. We never saw them getting taken off the island, which I'm okay with because I don't want it to spoil things. But at the same time, them being taken off the island happened within the first half an hour.
Yeah.
Actually. So it's not like it happened at the end of the movie.
Right.
Like, if in the trailer they were like, and by the way, this chick's a clone, I'd be like, why don't we know her name yet?
Right.
Right? That's a big thing that I'm like, oh. What I think is odd, though, is that when she saw her with her... Wait, why was there a picture of them both next to each other, though? The girl and...
Yeah, I'm not sure.
I mean, did he clone her because she was sick?
No, the picture... I think the picture was... It wasn't of her mom, it was the caretaker, I thought.
But they looked similar.
Yeah, they did. That's why I got confused at first, too. But then they start to clear it up.
Because I was like, oh, that's the caretaker's. Because that made sense if maybe the caretaker was actually the mom.
Right.
Yeah. What's funny is, okay, so Tristan paused for a second. He's hearing my fridge make weird noises, but he thought it was the second coming of Satan. Oh, oh, God.
Raptor claw.
Yeah, so he thought it was a raptor claw, which I think you can hear because the mic is on the table. That's funny. That's beautiful, actually.
That gave me chills for a second. I'm like, I know it's not that, but we just watched this.
Yeah, so I don't have a problem with her being a clone. I think that it was just an odd turn. Mm. I get the thematics part, but it's just an odd turn.
Right.
I like the villains. I think they were very... You know what the problem, though, with the villains was? Mm. They were very villainous, but also extremely incompetent.
Yeah. I mean, they usually are.
But this was levels of incompetence I haven't seen since the 80s. Like, movies have grown in terms of villains' incompetence.
Yeah, I mean, I just...
And I'm not talking about how badly they can aim. That's
right,
fine.
Right.
That's just the Stormtrooper thing that we're all cool with, no matter what movie we're watching. That's an action movie. I'm talking about, like, these guys somehow let the nerd... I love him, by the way. But
oh, you mean with the character sneaking into their ranks?
Sneaking
and
in.
Yeah, okay.
Staying
that's fair.
On the ship without any kind of surveillance, finding them.
Right.
Until, God, I mean, heck, they got the blood from the T-Rex. Right,
yeah.
Nobody heard that. Yeah. And also, the T-Rex didn't break out of the cage afterwards.
Yeah.
It broke out of its... Like, what? Did they open it up? Oh, we lost a few men when we opened it up and ate them, but then we shot it with some more tranquilizers and we were good.
I mean, to be fair, probably. I could totally see that happening.
Me too. So I think that's my problem. Their incompetence was so high that it just felt so... I don't know. It okay. just...
Yeah, no, you're right. That does make sense. I thought you were going to mean with them handling the dinosaurs, and it's like they've always had problems with underestimating the dinosaurs. Right, no,
it's the people that it's just kind of like it took you that long to find them? Yeah. Really? Right. And then afterwards, apparently the nerd guy who literally knows nothing, granted, at least you can say that that Wu was stressed.
Yeah.
But he, but he's just like...
He would know everyone that's working in that lab.
I would hope so.
Yeah.
Jesus, I would hope so. You come off like a dick otherwise. And you're a dick, but not for that reason.
Yeah.
Right. You're a dick, but not in terms of like you don't know your the guys working in your lab.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is odd.
Yeah.
Weird.
That's fair.
Yeah. So I think that stuff was a bit too much for me.
Okay.
Other than that, though, it was an entertaining film. I do think that the horror scenes were played up, and I loved it.
Mm.
I think there were more horror scenes than in the first one, I would say. And again, that was good.
Right.
I didn't like the close call stuff because it felt like everyone was going to get saved by everyone else at any given moment.
Right.
Until there were some moments where people jumped through crazy obstacles, and I'm like, but that's good.
Right.
No, I would rather have Owen jump through a T-Rex's mouth, which sounds really odd.
It was beautiful, though.
I'd rather have it.
Yeah.
Versus having it be like, but then Blue comes in, and then this person comes in to save Blue. Because the first one kind of did that at the end.
Yeah.
But it didn't do that every single time, I think, in the first one.
Yeah.
But in this one, it felt like every single person was in in a dire situation.
Right.
And then someone else came in to save them.
Right.
So it's like, oh no, Claire, give it 3 minutes. We got Owen.
Right.
Oh no, Owen, give it 3 minutes. We got Claire.
Right.
Oh no, Owen and Claire. Don't worry,
Blue's here.
I was going to say, don't worry, we got the interns on the case.
Right, yeah, that's fair.
Yeah. I like the interns, though.
Yeah.
Frankly, I loved how competent they were.
Yeah.
They were much more competent. Whoever wrote this definitely at one point was an intern.
Yeah.
They were so competent.
Right.
And so alive.
Yeah.
Throughout the entire movie.
I'm a doctor,
movie.
Not a telemarketer.
Yeah, they were extremely, and the reason why I say that they're interns is because she's a doctor, but she's an intern for that that setting
with Claire's group and
yes.
saving the island
exactly but anyway, so I think we're gonna wrap this up. Anything you want to say? You loved or really hated in the movie? I think I've said my piece. So for you.
The one thing that we haven't really talked about too much.
Uh-oh.
Just quick, but
mm.
That I really loved was the idea of Owen imprinting on Blue, to the fact of when they go back to the island after a decent amount of time has passed, he is still able to rekindle that connection. And Blue, being highly intelligent, like we've learned more about raptors in recent years, and just the levels of intelligence that they may have possessed
mm-hmm.
are staggering, like with primates and dolphins and us. So like, I love the fact, because there are animals that are raised in captivity as babies and then reintroduced back into the wild, because
mm-hmm.
that's the ultimate goal. We
right,
want to
course.
Bring them back to their natural habitat,
yeah, they're not
their
pets.
Natural home. Exactly. And people can go back years later because they want to check up on the animal, make sure they're still, you know, doing all right, they're not sick, or they're adjusting well, they're
mm-hmm.
blending in with other animals.
Mm-hmm.
And they do that, like, they have the bond with Owen and Blue, and the fact that raptors would possess that kind of intelligence. I was really happy to see something like that.
Mm. So, yeah, I mean, that's something that's, a good thing. Any bad things?
It was really hard seeing dinosaurs sold on a black market type deal, but, like, it made for good villains.
I'm just still convinced that $10 million is way too low. I know that they shouldn't be sold anyway, right?
Yeah.
But they're being sold.
And it is
so
a, really...
a $10 million for a dinosaur that could kill you and everyone you know just by getting, well, everyone you know in your family, by getting your scent and going, I'm going to track everyone else down.
Right, yeah.
That's worth more than $10 million.
Well, yeah, you're right. It's the short-sightedness of the profit.
Yeah, I guess. Now, granted, yeah, it's funny. It's like eBay. Are you saying that the people selling should have made a minimum bid of $1 billion? Yes.
Oh, my God.
$1 billion on each. Yeah. Maybe less for the herbivores.
Yeah. And it did make a really striking, like, that's the illegal pet trade, like, in a nutshell.
Illegal everything trade. We're not going to try to get into it. That's just how anything and sadly anyone can be traded.
Yeah.
So that wasn't, like, I'm not saying that that was either a good scene, and you're saying, of course, it's a bad scene because, you know, you've grown up with all these dinosaurs around you, that to see them be alive again and then be sold in captivity.
Yeah.
Although I will admit, it was definitely shades of King Kong, very much. Yeah. Especially when they broke out.
Yeah.
Although technically it wasn't that actual, it wasn't anyone in the cage breaking out other than the bad guy.
Yeah.
The Endoraptor.
Yeah.
But in terms of everyone else, it was the Anki with the
Ankylosaurus.
Ankylosaurus.
Oh no, the Pachycephalosaurus.
Yeah, Pachy, sorry.
With the bone.
Yeah. Oh man, that was beautiful. He seemed fun. Yeah. I'd chill with him. I mean, he tried to murder me, but I'd chill with him. I mean, does he think it's playing, or does he think he's actually killing you when he rams you?
I mean, that's, usually for defense. It would be more if you scared it would ram you.
Okay. Anyway, so, we're officially done now.
Yeah.
I think this was I thought this was a fun movie. Again, I've said what I've said about it at its core.
Yeah.
And mostly about trailers that, you know, the creators didn't have the, like, they didn't have power over the trailer.
Right.
Yeah. You know, that's Paramount? No.
Legendary.
Ooh, Legendary. No, I thought there was isn't Legendary owned by, isn't there a parent company?
Oh, maybe. I am not sure.
Either way. Thank you, though. Thank you all for listening in. Love you all. Before we go, though, I would like you all to remember, first of all, thank you for listening in, truly, from the bottom of our hearts, wherever you're listening in. And you might be listening in through either our Blog Talk Radio account, which is blogtalkradio.com/thoseguysontheradio, or over at our YouTube, which is, you can search up Those Guys on the Radio to find us there. Either way, thank you so much. If you guys want to listen to us, or rather watch us, you can do both. You could not watch our stuff and just listen to us over at Those Guys Play, where we do a lot of fun videos. I collaborate with a lot of other people, bring a lot of other hosts on the show. And it's a heck of a lot of fun. You can go check that out by searching up Those Guys Play, or just see me play some video games by myself, or talk about video games as well. Currently have the Matt rants, the E3 rants coming out, and that's a heck of a lot of fun, so you can go check that out. Also, you can go buy stuff either from our eBay, which is ebay.com/usr/thoseguysradio, stuff from my personal collection, maybe we'll even putting some dinosaur stuff up. If you want me to sell some stuff through the eBay, Tristan, you can. Well, go get Tristan's personal dinosaurs from his collection. You're like the collector from Guardians, but with dinosaur Star Wars
toys.
Stuff. Yeah, of course. Because you have to clarify with some people.
Yeah.
Remember when I said on the train dinosaurs didn't exist in referring to them not being made the same way that they are in the movie? And you were like, they did exist. And I was like, but Claire said they were myth. So I don't know. Also, you can check out our Patreon, patreon.com/TGProductions. And on our Patreon, depending on what tier you give to, you can get a lot of different cool things, a lot of different tiers, a lot of different video suggestions, although basically video ideas that we'll implement, both for Kekaku Corner, which is a podcast that we do where we talk about different anime/manga/tokusatsu/video game news. Also, different podcast ideas in terms of if you guys want us to talk about our top 5 favorite dinosaurs. Or something along those lines, or top 5 favorite dinosaur movies, or something like that. Also involved as well, different games that we can play on the show, different topics I can do for Matt rants and things like that. Again, they're all listed in the tiers over at patreon.com/TGProductions. And you get some really cool t-shirts, like the ones that we usually wear on Those Guys Play, or even sometimes during Keikaku Corner. You can get those over at our main website, tgproduction.net/merchandise. And if you want to follow us and everything we do, obviously subscribe to all of our channels. Or what you can do is, if you're not always on YouTube 24/7 like I am, like Tristan can occasionally be, because you got one of those newer smartphones, you can get on the YouTube now. So if you guys aren't on YouTube 24/7, you want to follow us through our other social media accounts, you go to our Facebook, facebook.com/thoseguysontheradio, and our Twitter @thoseguysradio. Thank you all so much. Love you all. Take care, and life finds a way.
And welcome to Jurassic World.